Anyway, hey everybody, it's Fight Club Hubs. Welcome to another wonderful edition of Game Jam. I have my buddy Lance back with me. Lance Ants in the Pants. And we brought him back for a second round of Yeast 1, The Vanished Omen, which is actually a lot of fun. I played that back in October of 2016, last year actually. And, what would you say, Lance, that I'm about halfway through the game?
Not quite.
Well, it's a short game, isn't it?
Yeah. Once you finish the next dungeon, you'll be halfway through. The second half is one giant dungeon.
All right. So, yeah, let's get underway. Before we go crazy, though... game seems to be a little loud. I hope it's not overpowering my
Let me switch to the stream and see.
Let's turn that down. There we go. Now it's not.
It seemed like it was okay on my end, but yeah, it doesn't hurt just to double check that.
Okay. But anyway, yeah, so I'm sure most people are kind of anticipating next month, which is Disney month in May, or Dismay for short. You could be playing Disney games every Wednesday next month for Game Jam. We're going to start off with next Wednesday being The Lion King, the following week being Aladdin. The third week we are going to be playing a one Donald Duck game and one Mickey Mouse game in a night. And then we're going to be finishing it off for the last 2 weeks being the Disney afternoon games. Woo! So we're going to get some Darkwing Duck, some Chippendale Rescue Rangers, some DuckTales action in, and maybe if we have time, some Tailspin. You know, some fun classic games. All right, so I am completely lost to where I am.
Yeah. All right, let's see. I'm pretty sure you have everything you need at the moment. Yeah. Okay. So you basically have to head out into the field at this point and find a mine entrance.
I don't think I remember it. Oh, yeah, that's right. You walk into people and they talk.
Yep. So you're going to go straight up out of town. And you're going to go up and I think kind of to the left a little bit after a little while.
Yeah. Grizzly zombie blows up when I touch him.
You're going to go north a little bit more before you head to the west. And remember, if you run directly into the front of an enemy, you will take damage, guaranteed.
Yep, that's why you go in at an angle, right?
Yep, or him from behind. Yeah, those guys aren't going to give you any EXP at this point, so I would just honestly ignore them. And those guys aren't going to give you much EXP either.
But they're so much fun to watch explode. Oh wait, that should go down to... That would return me to the original game, right?
Maybe.
Or, I mean, original town.
I would still go north more, yeah. Yep. There you go. Then off to the left, I think, off of here. What does that sign say? What? Yeah, right there. That sign.
The mine is northwest.
Yep. There we go. That's it. That's it. So the entrance is straight there, I would say, before going into that hole to the north. Not there.
Alright, fine.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot of treasure to find out here. I think you got everything, pretty much. Alright, so in there, your visibility is going to suck. And enemies will hurt like a bitch. And there's, I think, like, three treasures you need to get off of this floor, if I remember correctly. I'm going to try to...
Are there, like, hidden walls in here, or is there, like...
Kinda. There's a couple passages you can't see from the north, but you can walk through. Just, like, maybe two of them in this area or something like that. But you definitely are going to want to get pretty much every item in this dungeon. Oh, that ain't helpful at all. So let's see, floor one. If I remember correctly, you can get armor on the eastern side of it. Yeah, go up. Yeah, you kill that guy. I think you're right there. Kill him, get that armor. Oh, that's the heal potion. That's not the one I thought it was. There is armor in, I believe, on this floor.
I see a lot of cracks on the floor. If I stand there, do I fall through?
Nope. It's cosmetic. Oh, you're dead.
Oh, wow. Mr. Worm killed me.
Yeah, these enemies, they don't mess around. They will wreck your face.
But I like my face.
They don't care. Because I think if you go east from there, is there a passage down? Nope. Okay, so you have to go... You see the chest down there, though. So you have to go to the passage to the left and then loop down and then cut, like, straight across to the east. You might have to, go back up from there. What's that one? That... Is that the armor? There you go. That is going to save your bacon.
I'm trying to remember, how do I equip...
That's not it. It's not inventory. You have to go straight to the equip menu. To bring up, equip. There you go.
Wow, now I seem to skip a whole set of armor.
We'll be picking that stuff up before Dorm Tower. And I think there's one more treasure on this floor. If need be, I would actually kind of recommend escaping so you can save and keep your armor.
Fine, I'll take the easy way out.
I prefer to think of it as the smart way.
If you say so.
I do. Let's see. Yeah, that's kind of useless.
Yeah, I'm not doing so good right here.
Yeah, you need to kind of start finding a way down, which is more true to south. The second floor is going to hold more deadly enemies, but has something you need. Well, a few things you need, really. But one in particular will make things a lot easier.
No, I'm getting ready. I'm getting close to a level up anyway.
Yeah, that definitely will help. You'll get a lot more HP. Oh, Mr. Worm's here. Level up.
You said go down?
Yeah, should be like a little passage straight down. Yeah, right. Oh. What's that? Timer ring. That ring is... I'm not a big fan. It slows down enemies, which is fine if you're trying to avoid them, but it won't help your defense or anything. And considering you got that, you need to go up and to the right. Unless you want to escape and heal, it's up to you. Yeah, because the worms are screwing you up.
Oh, alright. It's empty. Thank you for telling me. Yeah, oh, wow. I need 10,000 now. Okay.
Yeah, because you're only a couple levels away from maxing out, so the requirements go up. But like I said, before you finish this, you will be level 10. At least those guys aren't hurting you too much anymore.
Man, all these classic games with their low-level requirements. Bad dog.
Yeah, bad dog.
I need to get a drink. I just realized I need something to drink.
Okay, you should be safe there. He does that. I'm gonna finish pre-ordering East 8. Oops, that was the wrong thing to click on.
Who are you talking to?
Oh, the audience.
Oh, yeah, of course. Talk to the audience. Play it up. Play them up.
Yeah, how about that?
Yep. So, what do you think? We think Rico might be able to stand a chance against Ogaflow tomorrow?
I don't know about that. We might all be dying a lot, to be perfectly honest. Not to say it won't be fun, but I know how that boss likes to mess everyone up.
Well, he only messes you up in two ways. He has that gravity attack for his first part, and then he, you know, consumes the soul of those in the second form. That's about it for messing people up.
Well, he doesn't do the soul absorption on normal.
Oh, he doesn't, huh?
No, but his attacks are still deadly enough that Rico's going to get messed up a lot, and if our stats aren't as good as we think they are for the boss, we're going to get messed up too.
I think Rico might be the safest person in there.
Yeah, maybe. Except, sometimes I don't think he quite understands how to play Ranger. I mean, I still feel like he gets smacked around more than he should. I think you need to hit that right. Oh, maybe this might be it. Yeah, try killing that guy and going down. To the right, and then down again. Yeah, right through the wall. There you go. And this is a straightforward passage now. And you can heal here, too.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, you can heal and save right here, then.
Alright, then I guess I'll just sit here on the old creaky bridge, and I'll save my game.
Yeah. Fun fact, my friend of mine who's running a Pathfinder game, a type of open source D&D, basically, for those who don't know.
Yeah, Pathfinder's a wannabe D&D game.
It's like an improved version of 3.5. It's actually really good.
Well, it's made by former members of Wizard of the Coast D&D's team, right?
I don't know about that. I never really looked into it. But regardless, for my birthday, not this year, last year, he got a map of the mines from East 1 that we're going through right now, and he actually used that for a setting for my birthday, and I didn't realize it until we got to the boss.
Ooh, he ugly.
And we were fighting ninjas in this cave, and like they were hiding in those barrels hanging from that by that bridge and everything.
Ta-da. Alright, I guess I'll just wander aimlessly.
Yeah, I'm looking here. So you enter there. So on the right side, and kind of a, well, I think you found it. In there is something very, very useful. Oh god. Oh, that's not good. Oh, if you need to, like, just sneak in there. Just ignore the enemies, because what's in there will save your ass, I think.
No!
Oh, that's unfortunate.
That's right, sword is on the right side.
All those other enemies showing up are screwing you up. Oh, man. Sneak in there, sneak in there. Get that. The left. There you go. You equip that, and it'll heal you just like you're standing outside.
That's the best news I've heard all day.
That ring is a lifesaver. So you can just sit there, heal, and then you go back out and fight those guys.
He's trying to eat me through the wall.
He can try. He will fail.
So, do some of these items have durability on them?
Nope. You do not have to worry about that at all.
Okay, good. So then I guess I don't need to worry about healing potions or anything for the rest of the game unless I'm in the middle of combat, right?
Yeah, I mean, even in your middle of combat, the healing, like, the only time you die would really matter is, like, for a boss fight, but you're going to have other stuff equipped. The healing potions aren't going to generally be helpful. I would recommend switching back to your... Oh, never mind. Uh-oh.
That's right.
Just be careful they don't come in from the darkness and ambush you.
I want to cast magic missile on the darkness. That never gets old. So I'm at a fork right here. Do I go left or right?
Let's see. Let me get back over to that.
Man, I forget, the original Yeast game doesn't even move a quarter as fast as this game, does it?
I think it is slower, yeah. If you go left and down from where you got the ring, you'll find another important item on the left side then. An extremely important item. Down, yeah. Should be all like straight down so you can't go down anymore. Okay, you want to go left then. There you go. That's critically important for later, when you get back to town. Oh, shit. It's important to switch back to the shield ring or the power ring when you're not healing for the stat boosts.
Wait, let me see the stat boosts again.
It doesn't show it on the ring itself.
Reduces my damage by half, okay.
Yeah.
By the way, in case if you haven't played it yet, you should pick up Voodoo Vince for the Xbox One, but it's also available on the PC Windows 10 App Shop. It's a classic Xbox One game that they just remastered. It's really awesome. I enjoyed it back then. I enjoy it now.
Not sure I've ever heard of it.
It's a classic platformer. Back when Microsoft was trying to find themselves a mascot that wasn't Master Chief.
Yeah, I gotcha.
And I was hoping they'd make a sequel, but no, instead they opted for Blinks the Cat 2.
Some of those enemies, oof. Once you get to level 10 and get the next sword, this area would be a lot easier.
Oh, he's too big to make it through the gate. Ha ha ha.
Now he's caught in the corner. Either way, that's to your advantage.
Because I can exit exit right there at an angle and it'll hit him pretty good.
Should, yeah. I would maybe save before you run out since you got the ring.
Am I able to save right now?
Oh yeah,
I thought I was only able to save in certain areas. I didn't know I could save anywhere. I forgot about that.
You can save anywhere but boss fights. That worked out pretty well. A little bit of damage, but nothing too bad. Those guys. Wish. Because if you can survive long enough to grab the third item of importance from this area, I would recommend actually going back to town.
Ah!
Never mind. Oh, shit.
That sucked.
Yeah, if you're able, you might have to try avoiding enemies to get those two items.
Aw, but I'm so close to a level up.
Yeah, you are closer, but the one item will help you get the next sword, the silver sword.
Ooh.
And that will really help your ability to deal with this area. And the other one you can, I believe right now, turn in for, well, EXP if nothing else, so. Okay, then you want to go back to that passage you just left and go, like, up. And then the second passage on the left takes you where you need to go. So, up. Up a little bit more. I think, yeah, left there. I see, they were right next to each other. The map I'm looking at is the old one down. Treasure chest, you want that? Good. Now, check your inventory. Oh, you don't have a wing. You're going to have to fight your way out.
I thought I do, right there.
Nope, it's grayed out. It's just saying you had one in the past. But that's fine, we need to go to the field anyway. So, select the seed. Select the seed in your inventory.
Okay.
And you're gonna equip it. And I forget which button is offhand, but you want to get back to the game screen and eat it. Use it, whatever. I forget which button it is, but you need to eat it.
Okay.
Yep. Okay, now get out of here. Leave the mine.
That's all I needed was those three?
Right now, yes. You need those items first. Because by leaving, we're going to get you the silver sword and some EXP. And hopefully it'll be enough to get you to level 9 or at least a lot closer to it. There we go. Yep, and then we'll make sure to get you a wing before you come back down here again. Because I think there's only one more item that you have to get, and it's just the key to open the boss door. That's it. So, there's not a whole lot left. Now, the boss fight, though, on the other hand, you might be spending the rest of the night on that.
Back to town, I guess?
Actually, you can do that, or you can head more towards your right, and remember those giant trees on the right-hand side? Well, maybe not, but you want to go find those trees again, especially the one more towards the south. Probably a little bit more to the south and then to the left.
South, left, what?
Alright, go back to the right there. I think there was a passage down. Yeah, take that passage. Oop. Go to the left. be near the northern rock wall of this screen, I think. No, go back and up. Right around. Go north. Right there.
Ooh, I get to talk to the mystic tree.
Yep.
Fear, despair.
That's right. Now I remember something. That's right. They changed something between the two versions. Okay, you have to go back to town first. In the Turbo version, if I remember correctly, in the Turbo graphics, as soon as you got the seed and used it, you could immediately talk to the trees and get the sword. I forgot in this version, you have to turn in the silver harmonica and trigger a scene, and then you can get the sword. They changed that. I forgot all about that.
Oh, you and your faulty memory.
Meh. Part of being human.
You're not human. You're a machine.
Nah, only on weekends.
I thought you were a party animal on weekends.
Nah.
Look at me, just running like 50 miles an hour right here.
Yep. Ain't it great?
You know it. Bam!
Do you want to go all the way to the right?
I'm trying to remember where the shop was.
Nope. Go up and all the way to the right. Go in there and climb those stairs. There she is. Talk to her.
What's that all about? What's the matter with you?
Can't decide what to make the colors.
What a wonderful ring that name has to it. Listen to thy song. That's right, we were talking about that last time. I think she was supposed to sing a song or play a tune or something.
Yeah.
Alright, Toots, I'm off to get my sword.
Yep.
Just wanted to say, there we go.
Now you'll go down.
Well, gotta get my wing first, remember? Yep.
Left-hand side of the town.
You can only get, what, one wing? Can you get multiple?
Nope, one only. East 2 started to let you carry a limited number of certain items, and that was it. That asshole. Remember having to bargain with him?
Oh, yeah, we had to drive him nuts to the point where he lowered prices.
Yep.
We don't need the mirror anymore, do we?
Nope. And that'll probably be the last one of those you buy.
Oh, where'd you come from, Timmy? I don't care if your name is Johan. I'm going to call you Timmy. Because you're annoying.
So now you have to go back to that tree and talk to it again. If you find the yellow tree, it'll have stuff to say, but it doesn't have any items for you, so...
A yellow tree?
No, the yellow tree.
I thought you said yellow tree. I'm like, wait a second.
Wait a tick.
Wait, no, I go down.
Yeah, I think it's at least one more screen south, and then you. Yeah, that's right. You have to go straight left from here, then.
Do 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 do. Ah, sorry about earlier. I was clearing my throat.
I haven't got a clue what I'm doing. Pick a color, green or black?
Blue.
That wasn't a color choice. Green or black?
Black. That's nice. Now give me a sword. Is this tree trying to hit on me? Leave your heart open to possibilities?
There you go. Equip that and watch your attack power skyrocket.
Yeah, it didn't skyrocket that much.
It's enough, trust me. It's enough. It'll make a difference. So now you can go back to the mine and start owning things. And you knocked off about 3,000 EXP by turning in their harmonica, so... And when you get to the bottom of the mine, you'll be farming some enemies for the EXP to get to level 10 before you fight the boss. I'm sure there's people out there who have fought and won against the boss at like level 9. I personally do not recommend it. Level 10 or die.
But I want to take him on at a level earlier. Look at me go.
Oop, you passed the passage.
Wrong passage. There we go.
That one.
Weep.
Since you did all that, you might want to save. There you go.
You're wormy.
Two hits and it's dead. So now you need to find a passage to the third level, which is this down a little bit, and then to the left. Nope, left. And should be right about there. You're going to go back. Nope, left. Let me start right. Up and up. There you go. Alright, so yeah, firebirds. And let's see. You basically have to follow that passage until you hit a fork in the road and you can make left. There's your... there you go. And when you can, you want to go up. If you can survive the firebirds. Level 9, wow, that was a lot of EXP. Both your attack and defense jumped up another 20 points.
Awesome.
Now you need 25,000.
That's nothing.
Are you playing with
a
friend or by yourself?
Yep, playing with my friend.
Alright. Oh, you still... Yeah. And then, yeah, there it is. Oh, those guys. Should be a passage north around there somewhere. There it is. Those guys are the strongest enemy in the mine. And then to the right is the key. So you probably hang out there and heal if you want before heading back.
Why, that sounds like a brilliant idea. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
mention speedy police cruisers.
Nah. All healed up.
Yep. And I don't know if you want to save or not. Next little bit. Well, you've seen how the enemies are down here.
Yep.
So. Not yeah, like you'll they're... go. Hmm? Go ahead. What were you saying, Hubs?
No, I forget.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was going to say, follow that passage.
Really, honey?
And when it splits, you'll want to make a right.
So what was that? The key was the last thing in here?
Yep, that was it. You're on your way to the boss door.
Oh, I see the boss door right there. I assume it's just a single path to get to it, right?
Yep.
Never.
She's a hit hard, dude. And they give you about 500 EXP, so I see.
Not bad.
Yeah.
Mofo just took out more life.
I saw that. There should only be like one more down there before the door. And at the door, it's safe for healing and to save.
Mm-hmm. Come on, heal. Well, at least I didn't lose a lot of life like I did last time.
Yeah.
This music is jamming.
Yeah, I always like this game, the music in this series.
Let me make a couple tweets real quick. I'm hoping that was just enough characters. There we go. So that's good.
So basically when you get to the boss door, you're going to save, heal, and just keep going back and forth killing these two guys until you level up. It's grindy, it's annoying, but it's the best way to get to... Okay, that works. It's the best way to get to level 10. Uh-oh. Holy crap. That damage when you don't have the heal ring.
Yep.
I mean, the shield ring. You know what I mean.
Yep, indeed, I do. That kind of hurt. It kind of sucked.
Yep.
Okay.
I love how he just pops up out of nowhere.
Yeah. Kind of, yeah.
I like how he just gets stuck, too. He's like, aha. Yeah.
It's like the door is pushing him away.
I got a complete silver set.
Yes, you do.
Because I am awesome like that.
Be getting you some other equipment, too. Give you pretty good gold too. Run. Mutual KO.
Wow, that was not fair. Oh, whoa. It's all about the MySpace angles or the Facebook angles. What is it now?
The what angles?
The angles, you know, you go in to kill the monsters at. Oh, yeah.
It's basically just doing him dead on. Any angle should work, but some of the monsters are quick to turn around.
Mm-hmm.
And these guys aren't even all that fast compared to some of the ones in Darm Tower. There's one group in particular that is, well, they're just not right.
They're messed up in the head.
Yeah. They're also guarding the most powerful sword in the game, so, you know.
No, it can't be that bad.
It could be a little hairy.
Down to 15,000 now.
Yeah, yep.
And
getting closer.
Charge!
I like how you started a charge and almost immediately turned around. Like, oh wait, let's rethink this.
Yeah, let's rethink this strategy for a second.
Run! Oh, that was close.
Oh, gonna be a lot of this, huh?
Yeah.
I'm about ready to just say, you know what, F it, I want to fight the boss.
You can try that. I'm pretty sure I know what the results are going to be.
Let's heal, save, and find out. Let's see, 13,000. Where's my calculator at? There we go. Nope, don't want to load. Thank you. I gotta kill 26 more monsters to make a level up.
Yeah, sounds about right.
If you're saying they're giving me at least 500 EXP.
Roughly, yeah, that's what it looked like to me. So there is a trick to fighting this guy, and it requires precision timing, and you're already getting screwed up. You cannot farm the bats, only the complete guy, and as you just saw, you get like half a second to attack. And they're hitting you for like 40 points of damage a pop.
I see what they're doing.
Yeah. At max level, it's not too bad once you get the timing, but it's really tricky to do, initially anyway.
Wow. You just keep coming.
Yep. This is probably the most obnoxious boss in the entire game, by far. Possibly the entire series, actually.
I can see that. Wow, what? You know what? Oh, I can't. I just thought of something.
What? I'm not sure how timer ring works. That's actually interesting. I almost never use it, so I don't know if it works on this version. I know the turbo version doesn't. That is very interesting. I did not expect that to work. Huh.
Only 500 more hits to go!
Yeah!
I'm in it for the grind, how about you?
Not me, I'd rather grind those enemies and level up, but that's me.
Well, whatever the reason, it's making the bats a lot more manageable to go after.
That's good. Except when they spread out like that.
No, we'll grind for a little bit just to see what it does.
And that's the nice thing about East, is that one level can make all the difference. You don't have to grind for 10 levels, just one or two typically. And that guy was hungry for your blood.
No, well, he's got to get in line with everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
I can just run back and forth and I can kill them faster than they'll hurt me.
Typically, yeah. Every so often, things don't go according to plan and then it hurts like a dickens, but... But this whole type of combat's a lot easier in East 2 because the enemies don't hurt you by running into you normally. They'll like glow and then you'll see like a swish type of animation as they attack.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot easier to kill them.
So you getting your PS4 to play Yeast 8?
Well, I already have a PS4 and I did pre-order Yeast 8. I mean, I kind of would like the Vita version for on the go, but on the other hand, I would like having it on the big screen for the better visuals and everything. So I'm getting the PS4 version first, and if saves can be transferred, then at some point I might get the Vita version for cheap for whenever I'm going on a trip or whatever.
Wee, I'm just running back and forth like a nut. Just stand there looking like a dweeb.
Yeah, well, if it works.
You know it. Mwahahaha. I just killed by running back and forth.
Almost there. So yeah, when you get this last level, your HP will jump up to... There you go.
Sorry, so I'm at the max level now.
Yep, and I think your microphone cut out for a few seconds a minute ago.
Yeah, I muted it so you couldn't hear my wife.
Gotcha.
Blow-drying her pictures. Playing my game.
Oh, can they hear me blow dry?
Yes, they can.
Sorry. Yep. I don't feel like sitting here watching paint dry. Like, quite literally. I don't got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Woo! Alright, yeah. Now this should be a lot easier. You're still probably going to get hurt pretty easily. But...
Oh, we got...
Did you save?
Yeah, I saved, and I got that time key or time ring on me now.
But you'll deal a lot more damage now, so that'll make things a lot easier. Yeah, they also like to do the damn fake out, make you think they're going to reform and they don't. Oh, yeah, that's a lot better.
Yes, it is. Damn little gnats.
Yeah.
Come on!
I know. He's such a pain in the ass to fight.
Oh, did I just... Oh, well, never mind. I took damage from when they were hitting me.
Yeah. But still, you're... Definitely looking like you're starting to learn his patterns pretty well.
Mofos.
Until that happens.
Did I just take more damage there, or that, or?
I think, yeah, because you're down to 79 now.
I can do this. Alright, we're gonna just go back to the regular that one.
You can try equipping the healing potion and using it. You might be able to do it right now. Or not.
I'm just gonna
okay. But the healing potion thing I wanna get used to being able to do because and some of the lair boss fights I always have some other stuff equipped for different reasons.
Thank you. requires a lot of patience with this guy.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I think I can get him this time.
So long he doesn't spread out like a net every 5 seconds.
Yep. Yeah, as long as I can keep the bats near me at a certain pace so that they're not hitting me, but at the same time, he's not spawning far away from me.
Yeah.
Temporary hitbox.
There you go.
Oh, I got him.
Yeah, one more good hit should do it. If you... Ooh. If he lets you.
There we go. Woo! I've got the Book of Yeast.
Yep. You can check out the yellow door if you want, but it doesn't really go anywhere useful right now.
Also, I have to return at some point.
Yeah, no matter speaking. So now you can use that wing to get back to the town. Let's see. Then you want to go to the weapon and armor shops to buy like the Talwar and reflex armor and stuff. And you also want to go to the fortune teller, right there.
Fortune teller died though.
Oh, that's right. We already did get that. So just go get the weapon and armor shops then. Then you have to head to Zepic Village again. Because he'll have a tall war. Wonder how much it cost.
Regrettably, it's from the Far East.
Yeah. Oh, he doesn't have it yet.
Still being cataloged, thanks
to the delays. The only thing you can do is go back to the original town and talk to the guy in charge of the militia. I don't know if you did everything you needed to for it or not, but he might give you a free one. But definitely go to the armor shop, though. See if you can pick up the reflex armor, and I think it's a large shield.
Only 5,000. Nope.
Yeah, Lord. Yeah, so...
Don't I have a Lord Shield?
No. You skipped straight from small to silver. So I definitely would recommend going back to the original town to get the free tall war, assuming they'll give it to you.
So then why would I want to buy all these armors if I got the good stuff?
There's a reason for that. Let's just say Darn Tower is a bitch.
And what, it'll steal my... something in there's going to steal my equipped armor?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, that's just prime.
Yeah. So you need to have a backup set. Ziptic Village is more on the right.
It's the starting village, isn't it?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, you're... I'm thinking of the other place you need to go. Later, though. So, yeah, you're on the right. You need to go... It's actually back at Mania. You have to... As soon as you leave Mania, make a left without actually going into the field.
I think I'm lost. I thought I used to know how to get to the starting town.
Yeah, you have to go back to Mania, the town, the big city you came from.
Well, that's down from here.
Yep. I think it's more straight down. To the right.
Yeah, here's this.
Yeah, and then go across the bridge and make a left. And now you're at the starting field again. You remember where the militia is?
Yep.
Cool. I'm hoping he gives you this stupid thing. Sounds like a winner.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Get myself a nice new sword. For slicing and dicing. Got an achievement.
All right, so now you're ready to go to the Ziptic Village.
I can't wait. Back to the big town.
You have to go past to get to Ziptic Village. From the big town, you want to go north and to the right.
Gosh, I'm so tired.
Long day?
Not really, but I'm just really tired. Now we're going up and where?
To the right.
Well, it says to the north, so are we going to Rastin or Zepik?
Zepik, so you're going to go north some more, then eventually you do have to go to the right.
Well, I went slightly to the right.
Yeah.
Right here?
Yeah, that should be about right. What does that sign say? Yep, you're almost there. Then you'll probably want to stop and talk to that old woman, Jeva, in her house.
He's cynical.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you can give him the silver bell for a ring.
Is the ring useful?
I never use it. It's the power ring. It increases your attack. I personally prefer the shield ring. I feel like I never have a problem dealing damage. I have more of an issue surviving damage, so. There you go. Yeah, you definitely want to talk to her.
Yeah, these two again.
Yep.
Don't fall asleep.
No, I want to fall asleep.
Jeva is the one I think you need to talk to.
The girl, right?
The older woman. Oh, you might have to leave and come back. Interesting, so you have 3 books. What are we missing? I feel like we're missing something. I'm trying to remember what you might have done differently than I did. Because normally I talk to them before doing the mine, then I do the mine and talk to them again. But you have everything up to this point you need. So the only thing I can think of at this point is just to try to go to the thieves' hideout and talk to their leader. I'll do some research in the meantime.
Shit.
Come on, I gotta make it to at least 10:30. That'll make it worth my while.
Yeah, I'm just looking here. Yeah, because you're supposed to be able to get Jebba to read the books of East to you.
But the only after something stupid.
Well, finishing the mine should have been the last thing you need to do. Because you have three books of East. Check your inventory for me. Yeah, you have three. Let's see. Okay, you need to leave Zepic Village.
Oh, really? But I just got here. It's so lovely.
You're going to have to walk out and come back in. Apparently that is what's necessary to trigger the next sequence of events, rather than just leaving the house. So now you can immediately go back and talk to Fina and Jebba. Go right back in. Now you should be able to go. You might be able to go talk to Jebba. If she won't translate, you have to leave the village and come back again. Now go back to Jebba's house.
Yeah, I'm kind of like dozing off out here. Yeah, I'm dozing off a little bit.
I kind of noticed your head drooped down there for a second. Oh, that's not.
Nope, not Jebba. Where was Jebba's house? Was it this one right here?
Down more, I think.
Wait, no, that was... Right. I think that was it.
Oh, she might be out and about then. I thought the house was a little bit more to the right, but maybe not. Yeah, okay, well... You might just have to leave the village and come back in again, annoying as that is. You could have just gone straight up from there.
There we go.
Oh, there she is. Okay.
Are you gonna tell me?
Ash the buttery. There you go. Now she'll read the first three books to you. I do find it kind of funny that they kill Sarah, but they leave her alive.
Sure, why not?
Yeah. She sure says something about, oh, hey, you know, you need to go talk to my, talk to the one guy. You may very well have to leave the ledge, come back, talk to Jebba one last time in order to trigger it. Because we're not, we didn't spread out these events like I normally do. We're doing them all at once. And the game's, not handling it quite right.
Yay, we broke the game.
Just a tiny bit. Now, talking to Jebba.
Oh,
voice that mixed in with the winds upon the plane.
Yeah, we already kind of figured that out.
Oh, nothing new.
Might have to have her read a book again, and then see if that triggers it. And with any luck, if you...
Nope. Wonder if the Fina says something.
And, well, if you go to leave the conversation, that might also be a trigger.
She's got a lot to say.
Damn, still doesn't... Do you have to leave and come back again? But you shouldn't have to. What the hell? I feel like the key conversation should have triggered. Do you have to have her read the third book again? Is that... There
Tell
you
me
go.
Devil's Tower.
That's
talk to,
exactly.
Talk to her son.
Yep.
No.
So now you can leave and head to the thief's hideout.
Well, anyway, I am very tired. I think this is a good place to leave it.
Yeah, well, it made a lot more progress.
Yeah, we managed to beat a dungeon. Level
you're
up to max level.
Yep, you're at the halfway point now for the game.
Alright, and then maybe we can make it through the rest of the game the next time. We could probably do this in July.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll be around. I don't think I have anything going on in July, so...
Yep, considering the next 2 months of Game Jam are already scheduled, I just need to get guests booked for June now.
Gotcha.
Alright. So, everybody, this is Fight Club Hubs getting ready to sign off. Next week starts Disney Month, so tune in to The Lion King. Same bat time, same bat channel, 9 p.m. Eastern. So, this is a varied Fight Club Hubs signing off. Have a good night.
Good night, everyone.